Hello everyone, I am so excited to be here with you today. I want to talk to you about values, intentions, and goals, and why we actually need all three. I'm actually looking at two different cameras today because I am on it. I'm on Instagram and I'm on Facebook Live right now. And so if you see me looking in two directions, that's why. In light of a mini workshop that I'm hosting with Miss Lizzie Rusinko, she is an amazing hand letter artist. I wanted to talk to you about setting intentions. And I wanted to do that especially if the concept of setting an intention is new to you. Maybe you've been used to setting goals or doing like actionable items. But in the world of coaching, the words value, intention, and goals, they're kind of like thrown around a lot and sometimes used interchangeably. But really, they're three separate concepts, and you really should know the difference between them. And once you do, you'll actually be able to implement them more effectively, and that can really make a big difference in how you're feeling about your productivity in your business, as well as your personal life. So, what are values, right? I think most of us have a general understanding of what values are. And these are things that are most important to us. They're those personal expressions and prioritizations of need, right? And everyone has a different priority order. And when you live according to the values of others, it doesn't feel good. But when you live according to your values, your life tends to feel more satisfying. And so values are things that don't necessarily get marked off as done. You would never check off, yep, I lived by connection. Yep, I lived with integrity. I mean, you still have life to live, right? These are values that guide your life. You commit to them on a daily basis. It's a moment by moment practice, and it's never like this idea of you've reached a final destination. So when your values are clearly defined, you'll really actually simplify your decision making process, which is something I think a lot of online entrepreneurs, especially people who are just getting started, they really struggle with, like, where do I fit? Where's my spot? What's my niche? And so really getting clear on your personal values is a great place to get started and a wonderful place to revisit as we set, whether it's a goal or intention for the new year. And I set both. And so values are typically defined with single word phrases. So that looks like, for me, I like to say legacy is a defining value. Connection is a defining value. Integrity is a defining value. Courage is a defining value. Purpose is a defining value. And so most people have like around 10 values that are like very, very important to them. And so those end up becoming your core values. And so once you have those in place, you can move on to intentions. And a well-formed intention really starts with your values, and it becomes a statement about how you want to show up in the world. And these are guideposts for how you want to be. How you want to be, how you want to show up, and much less to do with what you want to do or accomplish, right? Doing versus being. And so let's say that one of your core values is purpose, like me. Okay, and you might set an intention that looks like this. I choose to walk in my purpose. I choose not to compromise and go do this other thing over here or get a job that is outside of my scope of strengths or not my zone of genius. I'm not going to compromise. I'm going to choose to walk in my purpose no matter how hard it is. And so this is something, an intention is something you can be successful at right now, in this moment. You don't have to wait to accomplish a goal, in order to choose purpose. And as long as you value purpose, that intention will inform how you treat yourself and how you will make decisions for the rest of your life. You don't have to check off purpose from a list of things to do and then move on to something else. It's a practice, okay? And so the intention defines, it brings definition to your values, okay? And so once you have kind of separated value from intention, then you can move on to setting goals. And the one of the biggest ways that I like to set goals apart from intentions and values is that it is something that you can check off. And that's why I like to keep them. I'm a very big action taker. I like being able to check off my to-do list and scratch it out. That feels really good to me. And so a goal is a tangible outcome that you can work towards. Okay. And the more connected your value-driven intention is to your goals, the more meaningful and satisfying they'll be when you get to check them off. Because how many times have we gotten off-center and unaligned because you're taking all these actions that weren't actually aligned with our values, or weren't really, you ended up someplace you didn't intend to be, but you took all the action to be there. That's why this is so important. And that's why I've invited Lizzie Rusinko to come in and talk to us about setting intentions. And so when you have set an intention, for example, we'll continue with the purpose example, you can end up setting goals that sound something like this. Okay, your intention and your value will define your goal like this. I'm going to attend a conference with women who are running their businesses with purpose. They have a mission-driven business, or they have a mission-driven nonprofit. Okay, I choose to journal every day about my thoughts and my feelings about getting my getting visible. Sorry, my brain did there for a second. Around getting visible with my purpose, right? So maybe you know your purpose, but you've not gotten out there yet. Well, a goal is I'm going to do a Facebook Live and share with everyone I'm starting a business, or I'm starting a movement, or I'm starting something. Maybe it looks like I'm going to read 5 books on mission-based organizations. Maybe it is taking action and actually hiring a coach to help you figure out your purpose. Maybe you're stuck. Maybe you're like, why am I here? I have these talents, but I don't know what to do with them. And so you can notice how these statements were very tangible. Those are all things that you can do or pay for or check off of a list. You either do them or you don't. That's it. They are things you want to do and are in service to who you want to be, okay? So it's in service to your intention. It's in service to your value. And so, you know, really, again, the difference between values and intentions and goals is who you want to be in the world versus what you want to do in the world. And so I'm really excited to co-host a mini workshop here in the Facebook community. If you're watching this on Instagram, jump into my Facebook community. The link's in the bio. You can join us to talk about setting an intention for 2019. And the very cool thing is that this is the third time that Lizzie has run this workshop. It's called Your Words 2019. And we collectively as a community share our intention word. And I'll share mine with you now. My word for 2019 is focus. My intention is to be very focused on one thing at a time. I'm reading the book Essentialism right now. Let me know if you've read that book before. I'm loving it. Oh my goodness. And so if you are, you know, sitting down and thinking about 2019 and what you want that year to be defined by, I would encourage you to join us. Join us for the workshop. Submit your word to the link. There's a link in the Facebook group. Where she will take our words collectively and turn them into a beautiful hand-lettered piece of art, which is so very beautiful, so cool. I love it. I cannot wait to see it. And so that is happening on Friday at 1:30 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you can't join us live, which I would love for you to, please catch the replay. I know you'll get a lot out of it. She's amazing at what she does. She's an artist. And she's the owner of This Unscripted Life, a beautiful blog, an artist shop. So I hope that you'll join us. I hope that you'll make Lizzie feel so welcome here in our community. And I hope that you have gotten some clarity around the difference between values, intentions, and goals, and why you'll need all three to have your best year yet in 2019. That's all that I've got for you today. Thank you so much for joining me, and I will see you back here in the community. Bye, guys.